Hey everybody, Mike from GeoEngaged here with another GIS tutorial. Today, we're going to be doing a step-by-step buffer analysis in ArcGIS Pro using Jupyter Notebooks. The tutorial today was inspired by a Python book I'm going through, Python for ArcGIS Pro by Silas Toms and Bill Parker, that I'm going through to brush up on some of my Python skills. The analysis I'm going to be doing is similar to what they teach you in chapter 2 of the book, but I challenged myself to find my own data off the internet and to make my own unique buffer analysis instead of using the exact one from the book. So what I've done here is gathered some data from the Redlands Open Data Hub, and my goal today is to be able to find what schools in Redlands are close to parks and what trails within Redlands are readily accessible to those schools that are by the parks. So what we're going to do to start is define our variables. We'll set our geodatabase environment and we'll reference our parks, trails, and points of interest shape files that we downloaded off the internet. And I have this empty list called temp files that I will talk about at the end. So we'll run that. And then our first part is to find schools that are within a quarter mile of the parks. So let's go ahead and copy the park boundary shape file into a shapefile in our file geodatabase. And we can check that here. And let's go ahead and toggle off these data that I had to start. So now we have our parks. And what we want to do is, we should need our points of interest on here. What we're going to do is select the points that in the attribute table, their category is a preschool or school. So we'll run that, and now we'll turn off the points of interest layer, and we'll see our points of interest that are schools. And now we're going to create a quarter mile buffer around the parks. That's 1,320 feet. So now we see our buffer, and the next thing we want to do is select the schools that fall within that buffer. And oh, I need to adjust this variable here. Park buffer doesn't exist, but park buffer 1320 feet does. So let's try to rerun that. And we'll see the selection within the buffer. And now that we have our selection, we're going to use the copy features ArcPy function to put a feature class inside our file geodatabase with that result. So we'll run that. And then you'll see now in the Redlands buffer database, we have schools within 1320 feet. So our next step will be to find trails that intersect within 250 feet of the parks. So let's go ahead and clear some of this data. It's going to get in the way. And first thing we're going to do is create a new buffer of 250 feet so we can find trails that are very close to the parks. And I did this step because the data that I got, the trails are very close to the park boundaries but don't actually overlap within the park boundaries because of like the sidewalk and whatnot. And so this will make sure that the trails that are close by are included. And then we'll use the dissolve ArcPy function to make sure that any trails that are continuous with one another are treated as one feature. Because the data that I got, they're drawn on line segments, individual line segments. And they aren't a single feature even when they're the same trail. So this dissolve will give us an output where those trails are one feature. And I can perform a selection here on this one, for instance, and you can see this is all one trail. This is the Orange Blossom Trail in Redlands, California. Then scroll back down to where we were. Next, we're going to select trails that are within that park buffer, that 250-foot park buffer. And as you can see, now we have all the trails selected that are close to the parks. And now that we have that selection, we're going to copy these features into the file geodatabase. And if I expand this, let me refresh it. Should trails intersecting parks temp? We have. Okay, so let me clear some of this data out. Now I have our points, that represent our schools. We have our lines that represent our trails and our polygons that represent the parks, all of which are close to one another within the buffers that we defined. So the last thing that we need to do is clean up our data. We have a lot of feature classes that were created that we don't actually need because they're not in the final output. And then one other important note, when we performed the dissolve function on the trails earlier in the analysis, if I open this attribute table, we lost all of our information that was in the attribute table, like the park name and who maintains it and that sort of thing. So what I'm going to do here is clip the original trails that has all that attribute information to this selection. So I'll run that line of code. Let's go ahead and turn those original trails off, as well as our temporary trails. Now, if I check that information again, we'll see that we have all of our attribute information back. And as a final step, we only need three output layers here. Our schools within 1,320 feet of the parks, our trails that intersect the parks, and our parks polygon. So when I referenced earlier that I had that empty list, temp files, as I was running this code, I was adding the temporary layers to this list. For example, using this temp files.append on this temporary schools layer. So that at the end of this code, I can use the delete management ArcPy function to delete any of those temporary layers. And I'll go ahead and run this print statement of the temp files that we included in there. And when I run the next step, the delete feature classes, you'll see these feature classes disappear from the contents and from the geodatabase. So let's go ahead and run that. And let's refresh this file geodatabase. So we just have the three feature classes that we were expecting in the output. Our map has been cleaned up. And now we can visualize and see what schools are close to what trails. And, you know, if it's worth it to try to connect any more of these parks so that you know, people can bike to school or get around town easier. I went ahead and wrote a blog post on the GeoEngage website, which I'll link below, that talks about this as well. And you can copy and paste the code from there. And it has the data sources linked in the article. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I had a great time making it for you. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you around for the next video.